iPhone 15 and 15 Pro are here with some amazing new features and settings that go along with them. We're gonna start by talking about the one that everyone's talking about, but we have to talk about it because it's awesome, the action button. Let's start in settings and then head down to the new section called action button. I'll tap on that. Apple totally redesigned this section of the settings app. I think it's great, it's beautiful. You can swipe between each of these to see all the different options. Starts with silent mode to switch between silent and ring for calls and alerts. Then you can go over to focus and turn it on. You can choose which focus you want to turn on down here. Next up, camera. Do you want to take a photo or a video or a portrait selfie if that's your thing? Next up, flashlight. Turn on extra light when you need it. As if you didn't know, then look at it, Zach. As if you didn't know what the flashlight did. Next up, voice memo. Personally, love this one. Record personal notes, musical ideas, and more. I record musical ideas all the time in my voice memos. Magnifier, turn your iPhone into a magnifying glass. They're all pretty easy to understand except for shortcut. A lot of people have taken the shortcut action to the next level. It's awesome what they've done. And shortcut really is the most advanced option for the action button. Next up, accessibility. You could tap to choose a feature. My favorite, if I tap choose feature and come on down here, is background sounds. I could choose to hear some gentle rain with the push of a button. And lastly, no action. Who wants that? Who wants no action? So leave a comment. Which one do you choose? Which is your favorite? Next, let's take a detour to the camera section of settings. I'll tap back in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and scroll down to camera. Tap on that and then tap formats. The iPhone 15 Pro has an amazing camera. The iPhone 14 Pro did too, but iOS 17 is an upgrade for both phones, where now in the iPhone 15 and 14 Pro models, you could take 48 megapixel photos that don't instantly fill up all the storage space on your phone, because now you can take them in HEIF format, not just in ProRAW. First setting we're gonna look at in here, photo mode. Tap on that. I choose 24 megapixels because it's still only 3 megabytes for this really sharp, amazing photo. I think it's kind of a no-brainer. Tap back. Down here under Pro Raw and Resolution Control, make sure the switch is turned on and then tap Pro Default. I have mine set to HEIF Max, which is probably what you should set yours to as well, because that gives you the ability to take 48 megapixel photos, which are tremendously, amazingly sharp. You might be wondering why a 48 megapixel photo is 5 megabytes, but then a 12 megapixel ProRAW photo is 25 megabytes. So what's the difference? ProRAW is uncompressed. So if you are a professional photographer and you want to edit your photo after the fact, you have more flexibility that way. But for most people like me, and I'm just taking photos out and about on my phone, I don't need to fill up all my storage space right away. Apple did introduce some new iCloud payment plans, so. Let's go back to formats in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. And I'm gonna turn on Apple ProRes. And ProRes encoding log, that gives you more flexibility. Maybe you're using Final Cut Pro on your iPad or Final Cut Pro on your Mac or DaVinci. But most people I think should probably choose HDR or SDR under ProRes encoding. I'm gonna leave mine on log though, because that's fun. The real reason though I wanted to leave ProRes on is because it gives us the ability to clear storage space in a very cool new way. Let's head to the camera app. Swipe up from the bottom of the screen and I'll tap on camera. First thing to be aware of, this HEIF Max button in the upper right hand corner of the screen with a slash through it. I'll tap on that slash. The slash goes away, so now I'm gonna take an HEIF Max 48 megapixel photo as opposed to the 24 megapixel photo. And then if you want to clear up some extra storage space on your phone, tap over to video here and then tap ProRes in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Mine says ProRes log and I see max time 53 minutes here, which is not that much time. This is where you can tap a button and clear up storage space on your phone. So it's that system data part where nobody really knows what's in there. This is a way to clear it out. Let's talk about battery life. This video is not about how to optimize the battery life in your phone. That video is coming out soon. Let's head back to settings. I'll swipe up from the bottom of the screen and tap on settings. And I'm in formats here. So I'll tap back to camera and then back to settings. Scroll up to the top to general. Tap on that. Then I'll tap on about. Then I'll scroll down to the bottom and enjoy this new section called battery. Here you can see the manufactured date of your battery, Mine's August 2023. Zek has an iPhone 15 Pro. His is July, right? First use, September, and cycle count, 9. One cycle means whenever you've used 100% of your battery one time. We used to have a shortcut that showed you all of this data, and then Apple said, okay, pay it forward. We see your shortcut. We'll just build it right into the settings app. We see what you're doing. Let's go to a different part of settings now. Tap back to general, tap back to settings, to scroll down to battery. Why isn't this data in that section of settings? I don't know. Tap on battery, then tap on battery health and charging, and tap on charging optimization. And this is new. We've got optimized battery charging. We have this new 80% limit option. Why is this important? Lithium ion batteries are great unless they're under stress. So one of the ways you can stress out your battery is to expose it to really hot temperatures. Never do that. Another way is to charge it all the way up to 100% really fast. Fortunately, Apple chargers trickle charge all the way from 80 to 100%. So you're usually not harming your battery. Is it still better never to go over 80% for your battery's long-term health? Probably. My battery has actually been pretty good lately. If you don't have a good battery though, choose none, but I'll leave mine on optimized battery charging. Next up, a feature that I am so stoked about. It probably doesn't even belong in this video, but I have to talk about it. Tap back in the upper left-hand corner, back to battery, back to settings. And we're gonna head to the accessibility section of settings. So right here, tap on accessibility, then tap on touch, then tap on haptic touch. I know I just zoomed through a whole bunch of settings right there. And if you wanna join our channel, we have free PDF guides for channel members that walk you through all the settings in this video and a whole bunch of other ones. So that's on the table should you wish to support our channel. Let's talk about the difference now between default and fast touch duration. Fortunately, Apple has a little demo built in here to the settings app. If I press and hold in this flower, boom, that's how long it takes. Now let's try fast. Tap on fast, boom, opens up twice as fast. If you're as big of a haptic touch fan as I am, or you miss 3D touch, and we all do, we'll go back to the home screen by swiping up from the bottom of the screen. I'll open the Photos app. Then I'll tap here on Favorites, and then I'll press and hold here on Trudy. Look how fast she opens up. Or maybe I wanna look at this kitty cat. Oh, it's a different cat. Look how fast I can tap on Trudy when she's just a baby. Or Shaka, her little sister, down here. Look how fast I can make a sticker out of Trudy now. Boom, add sticker. You used to have to wait a second. This is gonna save you a half a second over and over and over and over and over again. It makes your phone feel faster. Next, we'll talk about a cool new setting in the camera app, but I need Zek to take a picture of me first. Zek took this beautiful portrait of me just now. I'll tap edit, and this is an awesome feature. Let's say you didn't want to focus on yourself. Maybe I wanted to focus on this light stand in the background. Well, I could just tap on that, and all of a sudden, I can edit a portrait photo focus after the fact. That's amazing. Maybe I want to focus on my thumb. Maybe I want to focus on my chair. Maybe I want to focus on my face. But this is going to make you look better and give you the ability to create some more artistic shots. And isn't that what it's all about when it comes to photography? That's it for this video, but watch this video next. It's about iOS 17, all the features you should turn off, turn on, and some walkthroughs of the best stuff that's included. Enjoy. Lights, camera, action button. The iPhone 15 is here with a lot of great new settings. One of them makes you look better. Another one, Apple stole from us. The third, what is it? Looks better.